the world needs more Brits and Americans getting married, if you ask me.
British-born Amy Atwood was positively giddy with excitement over the royal wedding.
First of all, it's the princess fantasy, isn't it? Everybody has that. And it's just, it's exciting, you know, it's the fabulous clothes and the horse-drawn cart and the palace. I mean, it's every little girl's dream, really.
It's an enthusiasm her American husband, Mark, has a hard time mustering.
Very good, darling.
But one thing they did agree on, getting high for their wedding.
Yeah. People like to have their mountaintop weddings now.
Mark and Amy chose to make their vows at a mountaintop farm in Vermont.
I was barefoot, and then we had a big barn reception afterwards.
In fact, mountaintop weddings have become a genuine thing, with entire websites devoted to the growing number of alpine options. But Amy and Mark wanted to take it to the next level.
We're getting some nice red.
The Atwoods wedding photographer, Jay Philbrick, a certified mountaineer, made them an offer they couldn't refuse.
I wouldn't say that we're really thrill seekers, but when you get an opportunity like that, I just feel like you gotta do it.
And it's funny, it's always the bride's idea. And if anybody's excessively nervous, it's always the groom.
As a rock climber, Jay Philbrick had scaled the sheer vertical cliffs at Cathedral Ledge in North Conway countless times. When he turned his hand to wedding photography, he saw an opportunity for a perfect marriage of his talents.
After my first wedding, I always thought I'd need to get a couple on that ledge. It's just such an improbable place to have a bride and groom all dressed to the nines, just hanging out casually.
Basically, we're just gonna get both of us out on the edge.
Shoots are scheduled for sunrise to capture dawn's soft, rich light. Amy and Mark show up at the top of the cliff at 3:30 in the morning, hair and makeup in place.
I want you to put a little bend in your knees, kind of get low.
After getting hooked up by the mountain guide, Peter Doucette, Amy is the first one over the edge.
Going down was okay because it was dark, so you couldn't see what was beneath you.
About 20 feet down the rock face, Amy reaches the narrow ledge, a makeshift pre-dawn dressing room where she will shimmy into her gown, secured to a wall anchor the entire time.
The burgundy looks good with the dress.
Soon, she's joined by Mark. Visible harnesses, helmets, and ropes are removed 400 feet above the valley floor.
30 minutes. We're looking pretty good, I think.
The skies brighten, and it's game on.
There we go. Now we got a train off there. And now work your way back out towards the edge a little bit, Amy. Oh, guys, the sky is awesome. You grab some of your train, at least the outermost layer, and just hold it up a little bit.
Wow.
You got enough light there, Vic?
Always on hand, Jay's wife, Vicky, with a second camera.
Could you hang on to his jacket? Don't do that.
Oh, my heels are off the ledge.
Meanwhile, our couple on the cusp is starting to feel more at ease.
Young man. I said young man.
You see, Amy and Mark are anchored the whole time, their tethers hidden by clothing and positioning. Still,
we had a firm grasp on those hooks the whole time.
Yeah, the death grip.
It doesn't. It looks like I'm doing this the whole time, but really I'm like this the whole time.
Let's get you both peeking around the corner at the sunrise.
Philbrick has done dramatic shoots elsewhere in the White Mountains, but his go-to spot for couples is Cathedral Ledge, where the drama never gets old.
It's the same place every time, but it's always a different day. It's a different couple. That sunrise we had this morning, can't get tired of that. I'll take that every day.
A bold, theatrical setting for sure, and perhaps an apt metaphor for a young couple, alone together at the edge of life's grand adventures.
So thrilled that we did it.
Absolutely, yeah. Absolutely thrilled.
And excited to see the pictures too.
Awesome, but no way, Jose. And hello to Amy's parents. They're watching us tonight. They're here visiting from Great Britain.
Oh, that's so nice. Hi. Hope they enjoyed the program there. Jay Philbrick has done 25 cliffside wedding shoots. Only two couples were experienced mountaineers. The rest had no experience whatsoever. But he says no one has ever backed out at the last minute, which is surprising to me. A lot of brave people. They're jumping off the cliff anyway, so you might as well take the pictures on the cliff.
God bless them. All right. Though they're happy, color the bride and groom blue.
the blue suit or tux is on trend for today's groom.